Hey everyone, it's me, Stagger. Sorry if my speech is a little bit off because I bit both sides of my tongue and it's really uncomfortable. And I'm not talking about, you know, to the point where it leaves bite marks. I'm just saying that chunks are, like, I actually bit off a chunk of my tongue. So it's a little bit uncomfortable for me to talk about. Plus, I'm getting a cold sore. So, yeah, my speech is going to be a little bit weird today. And, yeah. Anyway, so, hey everyone, it's me, Stagger, and today we are going to continue our Let's Play, or not even Let's Play, I didn't even type in Let's Play on that thing, but yeah, we're going to continue on the Randomizer Nuzlocke. Now, to be honest, I have no idea where I'm going to go next. I think I'm just going to go ahead and raid Silph Co. Anyway, so, question of the week here is... Sorry, I keep forgetting to click on the freaking thing. Anyway, so yeah, question of the week here is, what is your favorite Pokemon name? Now, for me, this was actually rather difficult, because my favorite name actually is from an evolution set, and I said Pokemon name, not names. So, with that being the case... I could not do Dinos, Zweilous, and Hydreigon. The reason why those are my favorite is because it actually does the German first three German numbers, 1, 2, 3. And I didn't realize this until someone actually pointed it out. I was like, what? I mean, the Articuno, Moltres, and Zapdos, that was easy to decipher, but then Zweilous, Dinos, Zweilous, and the other thing, it was like, wow, I did not realize that. Anyway, so... oh, wait, that's right. There shouldn't be... Okay, here we go. That's what I'm talking about. Who needs elevators when you have stairs? Anyway, so... Yeah, my favorite Pokemon name will actually have to be... Oh yeah, that was another thing when it came to the name, is that since I am a kind of a linguist, I thought, you know, not many people are going to understand what I'm going to say, but then I thought, you know what, forget it, you know? I am pretty, you know, worldly friendly, I'll go ahead and just state what it is. But at the same time, though, I know that not many people have that same... knowledge as I do when I- oh crap, that's a Magneton. Okay, let's see. I guess it should be fine. Anyway, so, I go ahead and state my favorite Pokemon name in my language, and then my favorite Pokemon name overall. So, when it comes to it, really, 5th generation had the best names, because apparently all my favorite names are from that generation. My favorite one in English is Alomomola. Why? It's just fun to say. And then, somehow I was kind of expecting that. I don't know how or why, but... yeah. Let's send Gigamon out there. So anyway, my favorite name in English is Alomomola. Mainly because it's just fun to say. And it actually kind of has an interesting name history too. It comes from Amor, which is Spanish for love. And then it has the word Mom in there, which is... because it's a motherly Pokemon, and then Mola, because it's based off of the Mola Mola, or Ocean Sunfish, and that exactly describes Alomomola pretty well. But my favorite name of all time, though, will definitely have to be... Clitoclack, which is the German name for Kling Klang. And although I will say that Kling Klang has the least thought out design overall, you know, it's such a fun name. Clitoclack. I don't know, just something about onomatopoeias are pretty, are just really great. If you don't know what an onomatopoeia is, it's basically a word that sounds like it's, that sounds the way it's spelt. Ah, jeez, the spike cannon. Come on, Relozo, I know you can survive! Ah, it keeps getting para-hacked. Oh my gosh, okay. Plan Delta. Use Mega Drain. So, yeah, Clitoclack. And it's an onomatopoeia. In fact, you know, we could have just done what the English version did, which was just, you know, cling clang and then cling clang. In German, it's click clack and click clack. In German, it would have been click clack and click clack, but no, they decided to add "ih" in the middle, so it's Clitoclack. And that's just a lot more fun to say. Clitoclack! Go, Clitoclack! Use Hyper Beam. I'm a nerd. What can I say? I'm a nerd that loves languages. I mean, I absolutely love languages. It's, you know, I am actually a little bit more of a linguist than I am a gamer. I know that might be hard to comprehend because this my channel is all about gaming, but in reality, I really do love language more than I do games. Even though I can't read anything from this game, I just love foreign words in general. And no, scratch that. I just love words in general. I'm a verbophile, and basically, you know, just the thought of, you know, how we can produce various sound, like structured sounds that came out of our mouth, and be able to understand thoughts and ideas from another person through that concept. It just amazes me every single time, just thinking about it. And then the written word too, like, you know, we have all these symbols that, you know, we can understand, and it's on paper or computer or whatever. It's and we can understand that and process that through our minds without even, alright, Mimi, let's go! Okay, yeah, I am not dealing with a Mewtwo. Even if it does just no pound. Anyway, so, yeah, I just really love that concept where, and, you know, it's something that we take advantage of every day, and it's something that we barely even think about. Yeah, so, it's the main reason why we have such abuse, like, lots of abuse when it comes to our grammar, because no one ever thinks about, you know, the whole process of actually understanding another person, you know, with these sounds that we structure. It's just a really cool thing, really. And by the way, just realized I kind of forgot to do our tradition where we go through the entire team. Also, I haven't really been sorting them either, so, yeah. Just gotta fast forward through this. There we go. So yeah, even when it comes to, like, you know, the language barriers. In fact, you know, language is kind of a universal tool. Like, the words can actually be a little bit more powerful than actions. In fact, speaking of which, we actually have surpassed that too, because we can actually create actions into producing words, like, you know, like playing a game of charades or speaking sign language. And when you speak sign language, you know, you pretty much can't hear anything. So then we produce symbols or signals that, you know, allow us to understand. And for those who can't see, we use our sense of feel in order to actually fully comprehend a, you know, what someone is trying to say, and, you know, in writing. So, yeah, we have ways to just completely destroy barriers, and yet we still have ourselves, you know, kind of divided in terms of, not Bisharp. I don't even want to look. I'm not looking. I seriously have my eyes closed and my hand over my eyes. Anyway, we have... So yeah, we have... We still have barriers upon us, like, you know, the language barrier. Like, I can't really read everything that's going on the screen, but I do know what each thing produces. Well, to an extent. I know katakana more than I do hiragana, but, yeah, essentially that's the same concept. I cannot read what's going on, so I can't really read what's going on here. So I kind of had to rely on using my eyes, my visualizing, in order to fully comprehend everything that's going on. And, you know, that itself is a communication of its own. Excuse me. Anyway, that itself is actually a communication of its own. And again, we barely think about it because we just abuse grammar, or we just abuse, you know, our senses and our, you know, knowledge of another language every single day. Is that a good thing? Maybe. But, you know, just that no one really thinks about it. It kind of makes me it almost makes me a little bit disappointed, honestly. But, you know, I understand that people have their different likes and dislikes, and languages just happen to be one of my biggest likes of all time. And I just realized... Oh wait, there's no double vowels, so I don't need to worry about the order too much. But yeah, Reloser should be next. Anyway, I've been playing Pokemon White 2 for a while, mainly because I have not beaten it yet. There, Pokemon Confessions, everybody, 2015. So, yeah. Yeah, I always had to worry about, like, the specific order of my team in case of a double or triple battle, or even a rotation battle, so I was like, crap. In fact, I just realized pretty much Reloza's entire moveset involves normal attacks, and this is only special. In fact, speaking of that, I gotta get my thing here. Yeah, ice is a special attack. So, yeah, aura beam is its only special attack. That's gonna be rather annoying. Oh crap! That's rock throw. Critical hit, even. Dang. Alright. Kinda had to focus a little bit here. Oh. That's an easy fix. Aura beam! Anyway, so I'm gonna heal up real fast. Sorry, I have so much junk underneath. Anyway. I'm gonna require... I'm out of super potions. Oh wait, nope, there they are. Anyway, so... Now what was I talking about? Oh, yeah. I'm not gonna fight the guy just yet. Anyway, so yeah, I always had to put in my three weakest Pokemon up front, or up in there, up there, mainly if I have to focus on, you know, what order they are in, and, yeah, I just take it from there, and, you know, what the sad part is, though, I actually started playing White 2 around 2013, but I just haven't played it for 2 years. And then I just got back into it, mainly because I actually finished playing some other games like that I was really invested in. First it was Pokemon X, then it was Omega Ruby, and then I got... Then I played Phoenix Wright... I don't know, Professor Layton versus Phoenix Wright. And then after that it was... It was Super Mario Sticker Star, and then I finally got to the point where I started to play Pokemon White 2 again. So, yeah, that's kind of that. Oh wait, Reloser is level 46, and I still haven't done the tradition yet. What the heck is wrong with me? Okay, so our team insists of Holiness with that insane special and insane HP with them. And there's its moveset. okay, I can do this. I can decipher the moveset perfectly for the first time. It knows Mega Drain, Solar Beam, Spike Cannon, and... Oh, come on. Double Slap! No, that's not Double Slap. I'll come back to it. And then we have Gigamon, with that insane attack and insane special all around... Rounded to stuff, and it knows double slap, hydro pump, a flamethrower, and come on, fury swipes. Wait, I already said fury swipes. No, yes. Oh, it knows bind. That's what it does. It knows bind. Not. Okay, so this does know double slap, and this one knows bind, and not double slap. It knows fury swipes, bind. Furious Lights Bind, Flamethrower, and... Hydro Pump, that's what it was. And then this one knows Double Slap, Spike Cannon, Solar Beam, and Mega Drain. And then we have Spooky, with that, which is our Glass Cannon that knows Fly, Water Gun, Toxic, and Hyper Fang. And then we have Relozu with that insane special, and it knows Aura Beam, Scratch. Come on. I know this. I know it used to know Leech Life, but then I swapped it for something else. There goes the streak. Of course we have Mimi with that insane defense and insane speed with that insane HP. It knows, it of course hasn't changed its attacks at all. It knows Waterfall, Flamethrower, Spore, and Withdraw. And then we have Salamando with that amazing HP, amazing speed, amazing attack and special, and it knows Cut, Bide, Conversion, yes, and Rock Throw, there, 5 out of 6, okay, you at least gotta give me some credit for that. Alright. I came close, but I completely forgot Reloz's new attack. Let's see here. Alright, so now... Here we go. Okay, use Double Slap! Oh, that's not good. Oh. I'm pretty sure it is double slap. Oh, wait, no! Yeah, that is double slap. Ooh, a Jinx. We haven't seen one of those in a while. Alright, Mega Drain. Oh, what? How's that fair? Alright, fine, you asked for it. I didn't, but you did. Mimi. Flamethrower, that bitch. Alright, there we go. Actually, it might have another Razor Leaf, so I'm just gonna go ahead and just keep it up. Use Flamethrower once again. It used Tackle. Okay. Waterfall! Now again. Who in the world hates these freaking sprites? I mean, like, did you see that Haunter? Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and show you it real fast. Let's see here. No, that's not it. I know it's nearby Cubone. Okay, that's Cloyster. And Cubone shouldn't be too far off. That's Execute. There it is. Okay, maybe I'm wrong. I haven't looked at my Pokédex in a while, so... Yeah, I have seen quite a bit of Pokémon, though. In fact, it says here that I've seen 149. So, if this was Pokémon Origins, I would have already completed the Pokédex. But, as you can see here, I only have a few left over. And... 62, which is Poliwrath, and then what I have to imagine would be Squirtle? Oh no, Charmander. So I haven't seen Charmander or the other one yet. Or Poliwrath yet. But yeah, that freaking... But yeah, that Haunter looked pretty cool. Okay, Rock Throw, it's not gonna do much. I stand corrected. That was a critical hit, though. Oh, look at that, it also knows Acid. Oh, and I get Poison. That's just dandy. Oh no, please. I will not let this be the end of holiness. Alright, Mimi, you're up. Oh crap, that's a... Oh my gosh. Yikes. Okay, it's level 29. It should still know Earthquake. Oh, and it uses Vice Grip. Okay. Anyway, so, let's see. My conversion. And now use cut. Oh, okay. Yeah. That's a thing. Alright. Salamando's not gonna take that crap from it. Alright. There we go. I have to go to the Pokemon Center here. Just enjoying the music there. So I'm pretty much out of things to say because I thought what I was going to talk about was actually going to be a lot longer than that, which is kind of upsetting, actually. Well, I guess something I could say is that although I'm not, you know, in the competitive scene anymore, I am trying to learn competitive battling for that one series that I just mentioned a little bit earlier. Now, although I do have my extensive knowledge of competitive battling from before, however, I came to realize I have no experience with double battles or triple battles at all. Rotation battles I do have experience of, mainly because of Telefang, which is the better Pokemon game. Anyway, so really with rotation battles, like I said, I'm not too worried about. All I need to do is just remember my time, you know, playing Telefang. And that's really going to be something that I am really going to have fun with. And I personally like rotation battles overall. However, I cannot really play any, modern rotation battle, competitive battling, all because of Edgy Slash. I mean, seriously. That's what everyone uses in rotation battles, and it's super annoying, and I feel like that really ruins the fun of it all. I mean, it's just like doing competitive battling with Dragon Warrior monsters. It just doesn't really work all too well. So, yeah, with that in mind, you know. Well, then again, I guess to be fair, I never really played any of the future generations of Dragon Warrior monsters. I've only played the first one, and I might play the second one at some point. Well, first things first, I need to finish up the first one. I kind of stopped because I was actually stuck on this one guy. I don't know what it's called because I was playing it in Japanese. So basically, yeah, I don't really know what it's called, but basically you're in this area and it's kind of surrounded by fire and all this, like a burned down city, and I felt like the monster itself was the thing that burned down the city. And also, like, I was kind of under the terms of Team Lock, where I used the very first monsters that I got, and my team consists of a slime, a heal slime, and an anteater. So. Yeah, not really the best team there, if you guys know exactly what I'm talking about. Basically, it's like, it's like Sunkern, a Ditto, no, a Sunkern, a, um, Okay, I got it. A Sunkern, an Igglybuff, and a... Yeah, basically a Sunkern, an Igglybuff, and I guess a Magikarp. That's the... Oh no, a Magikarp, a Sunkern, and a Phoebus. There you go. That's pretty much my team. You know, I actually kind of got lucky here. I actually didn't realize it was a... What? In the Spore 2? And it woke up? I was not paying attention. Oh crap, this could be bad. This could be super bad. Oh my gosh. Holy crap. 2 damage. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. No, not a charge attack. Oh wait, of course I'm an idiot. Why didn't I think about it earlier? Please be the Poke Flute. I deposit the Poke Flute. Oh, that's not good at all. Oh my gosh. That is just terrible. Sleep powder. No, I didn't realize it was a Mew until I freaking thought I was mentioning. Until I was thinking, what would the Anteater be? The Anteater's Phoebus, the Heal Slime is Igglybuff. Or Sunkern, and then the slime is pretty much Magikarp. Anyway, so yeah. But yeah, I'm pretty far in the game too. It's like, I got pretty far with the team too. It's like I'm at the second to last boss. And really, yeah, once again, I'm just having trouble with the, I'm just having trouble with that one boss, but once I do finish it, and I do beat the game, first of all, I get to laugh in the face of someone, and second of all, that was a dig. Wait, why did I do that? No! Waterfall! Oh, and it lived that. Waterfall again, there we go. Anyway, so basically, I have a pretty weak team, but it's a team that I'm gonna stick with. But anyway, yeah, I am learning all these competitive battling stuff, all because of that one series I was telling you about earlier about, you know, basically where it's gonna just be kind of like a side project and something to hold you down while I work on Pokemon Forever Silence, which is still in development, by the way. I just need to retrieve my files and whatnot. And I have little to no knowledge of double battle, so yeah. Oh, not only that, but also since I don't know German, and there's a character that speaks German, yep, I'm gonna be learning German too. Okay, yep, that's a Gyarados. It's best to put that to sleep. And use Waterfall! Okay, that did absolutely nothing. Holiness! Mega Drain! That's where having Thunder attacks is really nice. Anyway. Oh yeah, you can handle that, Mimi. So yeah, I'm gonna be learning German as well. But I don't mind. I really do enjoy kind of making those hack series. And I really do enjoy learning languages. Languages are lots of fun. Or at least for me they are. Okay, that's a Chansey, yeah. Okay, that's a Bellsprout. Okay, normally Bellsprouts are not that scary, but once a Bellsprout knows self-destruct, yeah, brace yourself. Oh, payday. Okay, that did not really work out too well. I think it lost its self-destruct ability in order to learn payday, so that's good. Just cut that plant in half. Anyway, so, yep, that's gonna be exciting. And I'm gonna love every minute of it. There's this team that I've only created one team so far. Out of six. Oh no, out of seven. So yeah, I'm making pretty good progress right now. And it only took a week to do it. Yeah, not only that, but I also have not hacked into Generation 5 yet. So that'll be something else that I have to be tinkering with. So I'm gonna enjoy this while it lasts. Yeah, pretty much. Oh crap. Boy, okay. Think things through. Conversion. There we go, that's good. Okay, and now bide. Okay, that did absolutely nothing. And my accuracy is pretty low too. There we go. Good job, Salamando. Another tough part of doing that thing is that I had to make something that represents every region that they're from, and I had to take in quite a bit of liberty with it. So basically what I'm planning on doing is actually trying to base it off the lore, so that way I'm not as restricted, but I'm still pretty restricted in terms of what each team has to be. At the same time though, I also had to make it competitive, because, you know, if you're gonna make a series based off of Pokemon battles, then, you know, you gotta know what you're talking about, and that is pretty much what I am planning on doing, is to make it seem like I know exactly what I'm talking about when it comes to competitive battling. And for single battles and rotation battles, yeah, I could totally do that. However, for other things, I seriously don't know why I did that, but okay. But for other things, yeah, that's gonna be rather difficult to do. And so, yeah, that'll be something just fun to learn and blah, blah, blah. I keep repeating myself. So, yeah. I know I'm on the wrong side, but, you know, might as well just get rid of this. Oh crap, okay, yeah. Oh wait, it's evolved. So, nothing to worry about. To an extent. Okay, there's nothing else around here. Let's see here, what else can I talk about? Oh, crap, didn't mean to do that. There we go. Well, I haven't been in here yet, so I guess we'll search around here. Oh wait, I already been here. I have a pretty terrible sense of direction. So yeah, I'm gonna be kind of wandering around here for quite a bit, and you know, you might see me go around in circles and slap your head and just be like, this guy's an idiot, blah blah blah. I'm actually okay with that. Oops. Because I don't really see you try to beat this game, and not without knowing the language. I mean, it is feasible. I've done it plenty of times where I've beaten a game without knowing a language. And, a notable example would be Off, and, Mother 3. Oh, actually, no, I did play the English dub for that one. Or, not English dub. Fan translation for that one. But, Tomato Adventure, Taiko no Tatsujin. I played through many games without even knowing how to speak Japanese, and I don't really feel bad for Brother Rabbit though. Anyway, so yeah, I played through many games without knowing the language, or really just knowing Japanese, because majority of the games I play are in Japanese. But basically, you know, when it comes to learning, or you know, trying to understand the game, what the game is trying to say or whatever, I mean, true, you probably won't even get it accurate, far from it. In fact, you can kind of just make your own interpretation of what's going on, but yeah, you can actually just make your own interpretation of what's going on, which is actually what I tend to do a lot, and most of the time is inaccurate, but you know, who cares? It's what you believe that's going on, and you get to make it pretty much your own story, which is actually something that is really cool, and I guess in a sense why I enjoy Pokemon hacking, because, you know, I get to interpret, you know, everything, or just hacking in general. I get to interpret how things work and whatnot. Okay, seriously, what is the point of that warp? Oh well, anyway. So yeah, it's just lots of fun, just doing something that you have no idea, that you have no knowledge about, and or have knowledge about, but, you know, change everything around. Basically, doing all this kind of stuff tends to be pretty fun. Alright, water gun! Even doing the things that weren't pretty much intentional. Exploiting the game to its limits. All that stuff. I really enjoy that kind of thing. I don't know, now my goal is really just to see a Charmander or a Poliwrath. I kind of want to complete this Pokédex. Even though it's seen Pokédex, but still. It'd just be interesting just to, you know, have that knowledge. Or just the fact that I've legitimately seen every... Oh, wow, Spooky's about to learn its last move. Let's see if it's worth it. What kind of move is that? It just is like a quick jump. Must be super powerful too. It's a normal attack. So Especially since it's just one shot every. Oh, never mind. Look too soon. Well, for the sake of diversity, I guess I really won't teach it. I have no idea what it is. And yeah, it's probably not worth it. Anyway, yeah, this is the thing that mostly confuses people, is that warp. Because, you know, that rocket grunt's blocking the way, and the card key is over here. Oh, wait, what am I doing? Crap! That's not good! Especially since Spooky is faster. No! 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 Whew! Oh man, I thought we would have lost one of our original team members. Oh, that was so close! Oh, thank goodness you're okay. Thank goodness, thank goodness, thank goodness. Gigamon! Destroy that little thing. Oh, that was too close. Okay. Ah, boy. Anyway, so yeah. Furthermore, I am very aware that, you know, I do have complete control of who gets to win and who doesn't. So, in other words, things are staged in terms of the battles. But, you know, I wanted to make it look as realistic as possible. And, you know, of course, because, once again, it's, you know, stage and everything, I have to make at least some kind of exception towards making every character. And that's going to be rather difficult to do, but, you know, it's a challenge nonetheless. Oh, here's where you can just, you know, sleep everywhere. Okay. Oh, right. Another thing that does kind of concern me about, you know, the generation hacking, well, actually just hacking the battles in general, is actually the fact that I can't really... change the nature... Excuse me, the nature or the EVs of the opponent's Pokemon. So what I may have to do is make all of the natures neutral and not have any IVs set to any of the Pokemon. Guess once again, if the show and not an actual competitive battling thing. So, yeah, lots to think about. Switch that. Now, one of the things I really have to worry about is the fact that it knows Spore. Luckily, this guy is just using Withdraw. Oh, wait. Oops. Oh, nope. Never mind. That works. I'm just making sure there's no other place where I can use the key card. There we go. Here's another place where I can use the key card. I'm just gonna raid everything in here. Because why not? Team Rocket raid here, but they didn't take any items. Okay, it looks like I have to go forward now because there's nothing else to do. Let me heal up my Pokemon before I fight Melody. Alright, Melody. I'll take you on. Alright, we can do this. Okay, you got Kingler. Relozu! Gotta learn its attacks. Wait, that's Hyper Beam! Too close. Okay, it has to recharge. Okay. Oh my gosh. But what if that wasn't Hyper Beam? But I'm pretty sure that was most definitely Hyper Beam. Oh, thank God that was Hyper Beam. Oh, and it survived. Okay, crap. Stats. I need to look at stats. Okay, defense is not that great. Defense is okay. Mimi might be my only option at the moment. Cause I don't have Pepper with me, so that dual typing with it being rock, it's not gonna be very effective. Alright, Mimi, let's just do this. Oh, yeah, super potion. Put that thing to sleep! Oh my god. That Hyper Beam. That freaking Hyper Beam. Oh my gosh. Let's keep Mimi out for now. Okay, yeah, that's another thing to put to sleep. Gonna go ahead and heal up Relozu. Alright. Flamethrower! That did absolutely nothing. Put it back to sleep. Alright, Holiness, you're up. Mega Drain. Wow, that did absolutely nothing. Oh my gosh. You can do it. I know you can. Whew. Okay. Let's go for Mimi again. Oh, Geodude. I can easily take that out. Waterfall. This is actually pretty... Out of all the battles that I've been through, this has been the most... Wow. I don't think I've ever been so scared in a Pokemon battle. After seeing that Hyper Beam, oh my gosh. Like, what? Alright, so now all you have left is your Electabuzz. Okay, no matter. We'll put that thing to sleep. Because I know about your rock throw there, mister. You're not fooling me with that rock throw. Anyway, and now, flamethrower. It's level freaking 40! I am so glad I grind up before I came in here. Because after seeing, you know, all those rocket grinds, I was like, it's only like level 25, I should be fine throughout this entire thing, and then I see that! With Hyper Beam nonetheless! What? Woo! Anyway, this is the guy that gives you the Lapras. Yes, let's give it a nickname. We will call you... I know, it seems kind of dumb, but... You know... I don't know why. Every time I do think of Lapras, the first thing that always comes up to my mind is always this character here. Wait, that's not even how you spell it. There we go. Ness! From Earthbound. It's great because we can actually catch a Lapras in Route 23. But, or Route 22, or, hold on here. Gotta find it real fast. That's pretty low in the decks. Okay, that's Moltres. That's odd. I thought it started with an... I thought Lapras was the same thing in Japanese. Apparently I'm wrong. There we go. Oh, it is. Just like Lapras. Anyway. I don't know why. It just kind of reminds me of Ness every time I see Lapras. And... Oh, right, here we go. We just need a... What the... Okay. That's its cry. Here we go. Its location. We could have caught it around here. However... Oh, wow. We can actually catch it in a lot of places. Holy crap, why didn't I think about this before? I could easily just simply use the Pokédex to see what kind of Pokémon I can catch, where I can catch a Dratini. Dratini or its, any of its evolutions. That is a brilliant idea. I'm so glad I thought about that now. Okay, that's Kabutops. Or Kabuto. Kabutops. And so it's none of those. Here we go. Okay, so Dratini can be caught in Cinnabar Island and Seafoam Island. Its evolution can be caught only in Cinnabar Island. and then its evolution after that can be caught in the Pokemon Tower and Pokemon Tower and Cinnabar and Seafoam Island. That's gonna be pretty tough. But it's good to know that I can actually catch one in Cinnabar Island. You know, after that scare, I think it might be best to heal up my Pokemon first. And there's still an item that I didn't grab, but I'll grab that later. I might actually grab it off screen. No, I'll grab it later. Later on screen. Or, no. Maybe off screen. I don't know. Yeah, I might as well just do it off screen. I gotta figure out what most of my items are anyway. So, I'm gonna be using the bootleg translation in order to figure that out. And, yeah. Oh, there's still one more. Alright. Aura Beam! And then... Aura Beam! Yeah, that didn't do much. Tackle! Whatever this attack is, Scratch. Alright, let's see, your Gigamon's already at level. So, Holiness, you're up. Oh, crap! Oh, crap! Oh, crap, what should I do? What should I do? Okay, this is a tough choice here. It knows Flamethrower, Waterfall, and then two other attacks. Let's keep holding this out. Double slap that thing. Oh, and crit! So that means it's going to be critical hit throughout the entire thing. Four times. That's good. That's good. You got it down a half. Alright. Use it again. Oh my gosh. Poison gas. Okay. Alright. Poison gas again. Great job, all. Alright, you're maybe poisoned, but that's okay. There's beds nearby. We'll give you some rest, and then you should be cured by your poison in the morning. Giovanni can wait. Now, I do have some antidotes, but I'm gonna save those for when I don't have the option to heal up. Okay. Alright. So let's see here. Let's go ahead and rearrange our team a little bit. Holiness should be up next. And then Mimi. And Salamando. And then those guys can chill for a bit. But knowing that I'm about to face against the gym leader here. Oh boy. Just calm down. I'm just gonna save because that just boosts my confidence a little bit. It won't help out in the Nuzlocke, but it just helped me calm down a little bit. Alright, Giovanni. Round two. We can do this. Of course you start out with a freaking Mew. Normally it would not be this terrified if it wasn't for the fact that Mew nerd four attacks at the start. Right now, it would have just gotten its fourth attack. Oh! Okay. You use an X... whatever. Alright. Should not be that bad. Oh yeah, War Turtle. That's fine. Mega Drain! Okay, what else do you have? A Ponyta? Oh, snap! What kind of move is that? Boomerang? How's it super effective? If it does know Boomerang, it should not affect Salamando. That was super effective though, that's the weirdest part. Okay, minimize. I can deal with that. Alright. Rock throw! Oh, okay, yeah. Confuse Ray. That's great. Now, let's keep Salamando out there. Oh! That's a concern. Conversion! Okay, that's bad. Conversion again. Alright, hopefully this should not be weak against fire. Or water. So... now, rock throw! That barely did anything! It's still super effective. Conversion again! Oh, no wonder why it's not doing anything. Rock is a physical move. Okay, I think it's changing its flying type, rather than its fire type. So, it's most likely going to be using withdraw again. So, let's just try switching out to Mimi. Alright, great. I already got its pattern down. Spore! And now, Waterfall! And Waterfall once again. Alright, we did it! We defeated Giovanni. And now, it is time to receive our prize. That is a Master Ball. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. Alright, I have enough room. And now, it's time to leave out of here. Let's first see if we can get that item, though. See how it is, lady. You allow me to sleep in here when we could have been captured by Team Rocket, but now you don't want me to sleep in there. All because we saved you. Yeah. No, it's fine. It's fine. I'm just surprised that you would allow us to, you know, be completely obliterated by Team Rocket while we're in our sleep, instead of, you know, other things. I'm just gonna get out of here. And heal up, and then we'll call this a good episode. So, next time, we are going to fight the 6th gym leader, and then we're going to continue on the quest that we have put upon ourselves to battle every other Pokemon, and then fight the 7th gym leader, and then we're going to go to a very, very special place that no one dares to even think about going in a Nuzlocke. Anyway, so that's about it, and I will be seeing ya.